Greetings, subscribers and other curious persons. One of the topics that comes up on writing discussion groups, particularly amongst authors who don't already have a huge established web presence, is web demeanor. What should or shouldn't they be doing in their social media interactions? And the debate divides into two camps. Camp one, the inoffensive school, that however politically charged your books are, you as an author should present to someone who is inoffensive to the largest group of people possible, that your social media interactions should be based around what you are apolitically. So you like water skiing, cats, and needlecraft. And you talk about these things, but you refrain from talking about disputes over whether water skiers damage beachfronts, over whether cats are inherently a better pet than dogs, and over whether needlecraft is inherently a gendered hobby. The other camp, the true to yourself camp, as it were, who say that you should be free to express your opinions in the same way that anyone else is free to express their opinions, and you shouldn't allow your author brand to get in the way of expressing a deeply seated political opinion, provided you don't break Wheaton's law, that you're polite in your expression of strong feelings. Now, those of you who follow this channel, have read my blog, have encountered me on social media, will probably have noticed that I am a fairly political person, so I fall into the second camp. However, there are some arguments on the other side. Potentially, I am encountering people who come across this channel or my blog as their first interaction of me, see me as someone who is a liberal, a lefty, a pinko, a whatever, and decide that even without looking at my writing, they won't like it, or that come across some of my science fiction and then are shocked to discover that I write stories in which a member of the military is heroic whilst not being right-wing, strongly in favour of proactive military intervention everywhere. However, I operate my social media presence, as it were, on two guidelines. Firstly, I don't think that selling books is more important than making a better world. So if I am losing a small number of people who would potentially like my book to the fact that I have a political opinion, then it's, whilst not the same as donating to good causes, effectively a reduction in my income in exchange for getting the message out. So it's kind of a political broadcast, this broadcast paid for by Dave Higgins. And secondly, I don't actually subscribe to the idea that people are particularly stupid. Now, having seen large groups of people in action, having seen people in the middle of a heated argument, definitely, yes, knee-jerk reactions happen, people make snap judgments in those circumstances. But over the several decades of working in law, I've noticed that generally people in very stressful, meaningful disputes don't actually get angry and rule out every single possibility, draw a line in the sand, and stick with it as often as people think. Most people are open over the course of time to having a more balanced and reasonable opinion. So potentially the people who encounter me in this format, if they do come across my work, won't actually have a burning hatred of me on the basis that I have a more liberal perspective than they do. And even if I didn't put making the world a better place ahead of making a little bit more money, and even if I didn't think that my potential audience are actually people who are capable of understanding more than one thing at once, it would be incredibly difficult for me to refrain completely from political commentary, because almost everything is political in one sense or another. There isn't really a line in the sand you could draw and say, well, this isn't political. If I post, and I'm not actually interested in water skiing, but if I did take the example of posting about water skiing, and someone responds saying water skiers tear up beaches, the fact that I've said I enjoy water skiing has already put me in the same position as if I'd said water skiing is a good thing, is more important than being able to lie on beaches. And then I'm in the situation of either responding to that or not responding to that, which is a political decision. If I refuse to speak on an issue that I care about, that is a political decision. Now, potentially, it might not be an obvious political decision, but say I'd already had a discussion with people about water skiing on that post, and then someone comes in and says water skiers tear up beaches, and I continue the discussion without addressing the point, and they come back and say, you haven't responded to my point. Now, at that point, I've ignored two posts while continuing to have a conversation. Or I close the thread and stop the conversation. Whatever I do, I'm opening myself up to political commentary, whether by action or inaction. Well, I think I've talked myself into a corner on this one, so I'll open it up to the comments. What are your thoughts? Do you have a line that you don't go over when you're appearing on social media? Or are you open about your potentially divisive interests and beliefs, provided the discussion's polite? Toodaloo.